want you to know that it's our time. You and me bleed the same light.
NBA 2.
Here I go, here I go, go. And once again, I'm yours in fractions. It takes me down, pulls me down, pulls me down low. Honey, it's raining tonight. But storms always have an eye, have an eye. Tell me you're covered tonight. Or tell me lies, tell me lies. I want you to know.
In their seat. Here at the Quicken Loans Arena in Cleveland, as the Cavaliers look to grab a win here at home. The Dallas Mavericks, they come in off the loss to Philadelphia. Cleveland will get the first possession. Timeout is called. First of the game for the Cavaliers. Rondo with it. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's check out who's on the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. On the floor right now for the Mavericks, Jamari Carroll is out there with Josh McRoberts. Then it's Green. Then there's DeAndre Jordan. And it's Paul in at the one spot.
Rajon Rondo, guys, really needs to operate in a system that's point guard centric. He needs the ball to be effective. Pushing, driving, dishing. When he has to play off the ball, that's when trouble starts.
And that's how you make a steal count. Turn it into a quick slam at the other end.
It was really a case, it looked like Greg Anthony right there, but if I can say so. It was really a case of a great defensive play triggering some instant offense.
Yeah, I remember GA as an irritant. And this guy, much like Greg, creating havoc out there.
And for Rondo, he's almost a throwback at the point, fearlessly taking it to the hole, getting knocked down, and getting right back up to fight another round. The thing maybe against him right now is what kind of guy, influence, what is he like on a team? How does he affect
them? That's a great point. And also, nowadays in the NBA, there's more of a premium on shooting and spacing. So it's going to be up to Rondo to adjust to that new style. That's going to be the question. Can he make that transition?
Well said. Here's Paul. Not going to go as it bounces high off the rim. It's stolen by Carroll. He feeds it to McRoberts. And that one is hammered home.
Flying high and throwing down the hard one-hander.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys.
And really, he does that one as well as anyone. Kev, you're right. That's like his signature move once he goes airborne.
Ball stolen. Green kicks to Paul. Now the feed to McRoberts. And the baseline jumper, no good. And it's the Cavaliers with the ball. Four-point game. Allen drives in. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
Well, Merry Christmas. I mean, that was a freebie.
Green, the pass to Paul. And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes played. And the shot is good.
Really nice way to get your first bucket of the day.
Rondo against Paul. Down low. And stolen by Jordan. Inside. A great 1-2 punch. Beautiful pass and nasty jam.
And nobody, guys, among the defenders stepping up to challenge him on that drive to the 10.
And Greg, he says, thank you very much, and sails in for the flush.
And those are the kind of sequences that tell you why the score is what it is.
Six on the shot clock. Pierce with it. Chris Paul covering. It's up and it's off the mark. He's 0 for 1. Carroll's no one around him. It's rebounded by Jefferson. The Cavaliers trail by six. The drive by Rondo. And it's blocked by Jordan. Paul dishes to Carroll. Oh, and they get in the way of the alley-oop. Not to be. Good play defensively. Here's McRoberts. It's good. Only a few seconds into the shot clock. McRoberts has got eight. And a closer look here at the hustle stance for the Mavericks.
They've come out in attack mode on the defensive end. They've applied pressure and forcing turnovers.
You know, another factor in their offense so far has been their ability to convert and score off turnovers.
And watching Al Jefferson over the years, he can be dominant and be efficient in doing it for all the... points he's piled up. He's always been around a 50% shooter, and for all the times he's handled the ball, his turnover rate is relatively low, so that's giving your team good quality possession.
Catching up on the changes for Cleveland. Patterson, he's checked in for Duncan. TJ Warren comes in for Paul Pierce. Manu Ginobili, he's checked in for Allen. And Jared Jack has subbed in for Rajon Rondo. Here's Jack. The Cavaliers again can't hit. Talking about Jefferson, it's not just his efficiency with the scoring. He's efficient, Clark, with his time on the floor. He's always producing a block shot here, a steal there, of course. All the rebounds, he covers every base.
Yeah, the data analytics folks rely on percentages to measure efficiency. But just as important as overall production per minutes played, Big Al excels there.
Here's Roten. After Al Jefferson's score. Guys, what a nice surprise Tony Roten was last season, especially effective taking over at the point, Clark, with Michael Carter-Williams gone.
Yeah, Roten put up a career-high 5 assists per game and really worked hard at the defensive end as well. He's one of the few talents on the Sixers roster that hadn't been traded away.
Kevin Serafin is checked in for Cleveland. To the middle. And stolen by Wright. And now in transition is Thornton. Here we go. Johnson's shot is off.
They've got a narrow edge here in rebounding early on. You wonder how much that'll play going forward.
Yeah, it's a game of inches in every play counts. And for Roden last season, he even took on more of a scorer's mentality. Went up in points, went down in field goal percentage. But like a boxer, he gets a little extra credit for pushing the action.
And, you know, talking about Roten, I think the next step in his development is to produce at the same level but with greater efficiency. Too often his highlight reel passes led to turnovers. He would gamble defensively, too. That's, to me, just a young player growing up on the job.
And the Cavaliers call time here.
Yeah, just frustrated by their lack of production offensively, and I can't blame them. I mean, they're getting the looks, but the shots just aren't falling.
Yeah, and the slump that they're having shooting the ball can take its toll on you if you're not mentally strong. So I like this time out here to try to get those guys reset and refocused.
The Cavaliers trail by 10. Outside check. Ginobili outside. Takes a shot at the elbow. Offensive rebound. Timeout called, Cleveland. In addition to going over the game plan and making whatever necessary adjustments have to be made, Greg, this timeout also the time for players to get rehydrated or hydrate for the first time with some Gatorade. Plenty of basketball still to be played here, and they have to get recharged.
That's a great point. Without proper hydration, a player can completely run out of gas down the stretch of a game, and that's something that none of these guys can afford to have happen. If you're going to battle all the way to the finish, you have got to be hydrated.
We've got 1:13 left in the first. Outside Jack. Patterson, the screen. Right wing. Five to shoot. Here's Serafin. No good. And the Mavericks going the other way now.
Rebounding is going to be the focal point for them in this one, fellas. I can feel it.
It always is, and it has been so far, and they've gotten a nice edge on the glass.
Now, here is Jack. Tony Roten missing his last shot, and that one's good.
Boy, I love the great assist that time by Jack.
Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. And a wide-open look for Thornton. A three-pointer is right on target. Thornton's got 5 points so far.
Their defense just hasn't been able to slow them down.
And that's a big reason why they're trailing, surrendering too many easy baskets.
Unloads from 9. Cleveland the rebound. And it's Patterson finishing it off.
And that's a huge play. I mean, they need more like it because second chance points are going to be key in this game.
Mm-hmm, probably so. That's usually a crucial element to any comeback.
Yeah, and if you look at it, had they been converting those...
And we reached the end of the first quarter. It's Dallas. They lead by 9. We'll get things started in the second quarter when we return. Well, not exactly a close game so far, but as the second quarter starts here, plenty of time for a comeback. And what do you think, guys, about Dallas here in this one?
Really active hands early on here as they're able to acquire several steals.
Well, they've really been aggressive guys on defense, and it's paid off, so why stop? Keep it up.
We've got Allen. Jefferson is out there with Duncan. Then it's Pierce. And it's Rondo in the point guard position. That's the group for Cleveland going right now here in the second. The drive by Green on the wing. Not enough on that one as it misses. The Cavaliers trail by 9. DeAndre Jordan has been extremely productive over 7 years. That makes it even more unbelievable that there was some question, Clark, as to his commitment to basketball coming into the league.
Yeah, you know, on talent and athleticism alone, he would have been a top 10 pick for sure, but he slipped to the second round, and he's made good on it, though.
And he hits it and gets hacked on the play. A three-point possibility if he can convert the free throw.
And for Big Al Jefferson, he's been a great player in this league, but he hasn't played on that many great teams, and he's never made an all-star team. Hard to imagine.
Here's Paul. And the dunk by Jordan.
And a few more points tacked on to their lead in the cruelest way possible.
You're right. Those putback jams sting, don't they, my goodness?
Yeah, they really hurt you. I mean, the defense forces a miss and then can't rebound it and finish off the defense. They're hanging their heads in their chest now.
And for Al Jefferson, never making an all-star team, he's got the numbers on offense to get him there. People just feel he's probably, what, Clark, one-dimensional?
Well, you know, even though the all-star game has no defense for the most part, you usually need to play a little bit up D to have a chance to get there.
Paul kicks to McRoberts. Outside Carroll. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Carroll's got five now.
A delicious dime from Chris Paul there.
Here's the pass to Jefferson. Can they get it? Offensive rebound. Feeds it to Rondo. And even after two offensive rebounds, they just can't get the lid off. And the wide open shot from Green. And another basket for Dallas.
And they seem to have gotten something out of almost every possession. Their defense has been just as good, just a tremendous performance all the way around.
Yeah, and they're doing it in hostile territory, too. I mean, don't forget about that part of it, which makes it even more impressive.
You can't afford to get him that kind of a look.
Well, you know, he came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you've got to do a better job of fighting over and through that.
Jordan with it. Now Pierce defending. Now Cleveland moving it up. It's deflected. From deep, Green. It's rebounded by Cleveland.
Boy, from my angle, it looked like it was in the bottom of the net. Looked good from here.
Yeah, I'm about as shocked as you are, Clark.
And pushing it up is Dallas. The Mavericks again in transition. The Cavaliers trail by 13. Nobody near Allen. A three-pointer is right on target. Allen's got 5 points so far.
You know, maybe he's not one of the elite sharpshooters, but even still, that's not a shot that D can afford to give.
And it's Paul penetrating. Good D by Rondo.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
Allen outside. Duncan at the elbow. To the paint. And Jefferson throws it down hard.
Tim Duncan, even in his advanced years, showing you that great vision and still getting it done. Nice pass. Tell you what, he can do a lot more damage to that rim than that when he wants to.
And you know, Clark, with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one.
Me too.
Well, I tell you what, I'm glad he didn't, because otherwise we'd probably have a 45-minute delay here if he shattered to the backboard.
And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
Can't be any surprise to you that Tim Duncan, folks, last year became the leading rebounder of all active players, passed up Kevin Garnett for that honorable distinction. We're talking 15,000 rebounds total over 18 seasons.
Looking at who's out there now for the Cavaliers. Patterson is checked in for Jefferson. Warren comes in for Paul Pierce. Manu Ginobili's checked in for Allen. And Jared Jack is subbed in for Rajon Rondo. And that one's good, Roten. Getting back to Duncan's rebounding, he's always had the great size and wingspan and timing, and he really positions himself well for those rebounds. But what seems to separate him is his quiet toughness. He'll never back down.
Yeah, it's hard. You know, he's not a guy that's going to yell or pump his fist. He's not going to flex his muscles to the crowd. He just silently assassinates you.
Well said.
On the floor.
You're right. You're so right. Thornton. He dents the rim with a two-handed slam. Wow.
Boy, he threw out some punishment with that two-hand throwdown.
And Clark, now's the time to do it. Continue to attack that rim.
Jack dishes to Ginobili. And taken away by Johnson. And here we go. The Mavericks on a fast break. Roten with the ball. And Reich kicks to Roten. Dishes it to Henson. Outside for Thornton. Johnson outside. That's tipped. Now Cleveland moving it up. He lobs it up.
Well, they need those kinds of plays right now. I mean, smart defense generating some offense.
And really, Clark, that's the way you get yourself back into the game. Key stops and then try to get out in transition for some easy ones.
Roten, the pass to Johnson. And Thornton gets it to go on the assist by Johnson. Thornton's got 4 points in the quarter.
Some defensive breakdowns are starting to show up now. Their last four buckets allowed have come from very close range.
Yeah, high percentage shots are what they are getting in terms of the attempts, and that's just not going to get it done. They've got to figure it out.
Here's Jack. And the rebound goes to the Mavericks. Henson's got his third rebound tonight. Here's Roten. So the whistle blows on the shot, and two free throws for the contact right there.
Nice work to get it inside and draw the contact.
Exactly. The defense determined not to allow the easy layup right there. They'll settle for making him earn the free throws.
And the Cavaliers making a change here. Servin's checked in. Cole Aldrich, he's checked in for Dallas. Green comes in for Marcus Thornton. And here is Jack. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. Fires from 18. There's Green with the three. He got it up that time, but it wouldn't fall for him. So we've reached the end of the first half of play. Welcome back, everybody. Third quarter just about to get going here in what has been so far a runaway game.
They've been ineffective in this one. Just no slowing down for Thornton. 9 points, and he's chalked up one three-pointer on the day as well.
And Clark, I'm sure that won't be the last one. A lot of times he can get hot and stay hot from beyond.
Well, we're getting back to the action now. It's been a one-team show so far. We'll see if that changes here in the third. You look at Marcus Thornton, he's really been playing well.
And in terms of points in that first half, you know, he's now at a point where we expect him to perform that way.
And Greg, that tells you all you need to know about what a talent he is. I mean, I'll bet he adds a lot more to his totals after the break.
Here's who Rick Carlisle starting the second half with. Green out there with Paul. Then it's Damari Carroll. Then there's Josh McRoberts. And it's Jordan. Boom, he jams it straight down.
And that's the kind of lead pass we've come to expect from him. And guys, looking at Jarrett Jack, one word comes to mind: professional. I mean, he's as solid as they come. Tough, capable, experienced. And he proved it all again last season.
Second half of basketball, just over a minute played so far. And it's Paul penetrating. Paul missing again.
If he can improve on what's been a shaky day for him thus far, they could stretch this lead out.
Here's Jack. The shot, no good. Paul with the defensive effort.
Boy, I tell you what, the complexion of this game would be completely different if he'd shot the ball anything like he's capable of.
Way to attack there and then create the contact.
Really as close as you can get to an and one right there. He almost had it.
He hits the second from the line. Third quarter of basketball, about a minute and a half in. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
They got to find something, you're right. Jack dishes to Serafin. Inside, tries from seven.
That's all you, man.
Nice spin off the left rim and in. Carroll's got seven.
Room service delivery right there, fellas. Wonderful entry feed.
Timeout called, Cleveland. Well, I'm sure you guys have heard this, that the nickname that has been given to Damari Carroll, the Junkyard Dog, I think it's apropos. Kid drafted out of Missouri back in the 2009 draft.
Yeah, and he actually had to show perseverance to hang around as he bounced around a bit. But I think he's found a home now.
And so here's Cleveland. They trail by 14. Up next for them is the Pacers in Indianapolis. That will be a getaway game for them, a one-game road trip. Patterson, the screen. Outside Jack. Down to five on the shot clock. Shot from free throw range. Patterson, that's good. Patterson's got six.
And Carroll, an energy player who's developed a reliable three-point stroke. I mean, he can also hurt you in transition. He's got terrific size and athleticism, and he also really knows how to play without the basketball. And Kevin, the knack for the offensive rebound, a big part of what makes this guy special.
Not to mention, Greg, his ability to finish with strength just like that.
Yeah, he's an invaluable asset for them to have, no question about it.
And Jack kicks to Patterson. No good on the three.
And Carroll, by advanced stats, one of the most productive small forwards in our league. I mean, one thing I like, even as he's developed into a three-point threat, he still has an instinct for cutting to the rim off the ball when his defender turns his head. I mean, one of the things I think that allows his team to be so good is his understanding of how to play the game.
The shot's good from Paul. The Cavaliers trail by 16. Third quarter of basketball here in just a little under 3.5 minutes gone by. Patterson passes to Serafin. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
That's something they need to do more of. Get after it on the glass. Go get those boards.
Clark, it wouldn't hurt. Some extra possessions would definitely help narrow the gap and maybe swing the momentum.
Well, at this point in his career, Clark, it's safe to call Chris Paul one of the all-time great point guards.
Yeah, without question. I mean, for a long time, it was hard to argue that Chris Paul wasn't the top point guard in the league. Even now, you can make arguments for others, but Paul is always going to be in the conversation.
A platoon swap here for Cleveland. Screen by Jefferson. Pierce dishes to Jefferson. And he dunks it after the pick frees him up.
You know, he's not your typical NBA center in terms of height, guys, but he plays as big as any of them, thanks to his incredible bounceability.
Here's Roten. Can't get it to go. Excellent D there from Allen.
And with Paul, it is all about his consistency. Other point guards will have better years or stretches than him, but he just puts up huge numbers year in and year out, literally like clockwork.
Over to the wing. Here's Roten. Dallas again missing.
But that would have been lucky had it fallen. Poor shot selection.
Yeah, look at the coach's face and the expression. It says all over it, are you kidding me?
Rondo drives in. It's rebounded by Dallas.
You know, it's amazing to me how little fanfare CP3 gets. I mean, he's not a flashy player, but you look at his effectiveness on the court, and he's a once-in-a-generation kind of talent. I mean, he's done it all his entire career.
Timeout called, Cleveland.
Way too many shots in close, and he's got to get his guys to cut that down. In terms of points in the paint.
Clearly the reason for the timeout, Greg. I mean, he wants his guys to toughen up inside and start protecting the rim.
Manu Ginobili, he's checked in for Cleveland. And a new group getting ready for Dallas. Cole Aldrich, he's checked in for DeAndre Jordan. Humphries comes in for Josh McRoberts. Wright, he's checked in for Damari Carroll. And it's Thornton in for Chris Paul. Here's Jefferson, and it's good coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. Rondo's got three assists now in this one. Kicks it to Aldrich. And it's Humphries, top of the key.
Get Marcus.
Thornton against Allen. And Allen with the block. Outside Rondo. He dishes it to Jefferson. Fades and shoots. Works a big height bouncing, goes in. Jefferson's got 14 points.
You know, as soon as he recognized the height mismatch, he immediately pulled up for the jumper.
And Greg, that's just good basketball. Come on, good basketball there. Clean look from that range. He's got to take it.
Here's Allen. He's got five. Here's Pierce. It's rebounded by Thornton.
And he has slipped into a funk, Clark. You can see the confidence is shaken.
Yeah, it really is. I mean, he's very much deflated. The basket looks a lot smaller to him at this point, and the only way you can get out of it is to work yourself out of it.
Humphries kicks to Roten. Nice pass. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup. He's got eight.
You know what? That's what you like to see. A perfect pass leading him right into the shot. Didn't even have to break stride.
4 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. That freed up. Nice work off the pick.
You know, the defense has got to do a much better job of fighting over those screens.
And, Greg, especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know he doesn't miss too many open looks like that.
The kick out to Wright. That's good from 17 feet away. Wright's got his first 2 points.
Well, there you go. I mean, if they're going to keep giving up open jumpers, they're going to keep getting burned.
Well, through three quarters of play, down. And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know. We've got Pierce, Ginobili out there with Jarrett Jack. Then there's Al Jefferson. And it's Duncan in at the power forward. That's the five for Cleveland right now. And Jefferson gets it to go.
I love how he establishes his post position inside before he converts.
That's good. And that's 11 points for Jordan. The Cavaliers trail by 15. Here's Pierce. That falls, nice feed that time for Manu Ginobili.
Very high quality shot. Can't get enough of those.
And the foul on Jarrett Jack. That's his first foul. The Cavaliers making a switch here. Seraphin's checked in. On defense, Cleveland. And they double up Jordan. Here's Henson. And there's the whistle, fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. Tim Duncan picks one up. Mark, when you take a look at John Henson, you see one thing, length.
Yeah, a lot of it, too. I mean, he measures 6'9 with a 7'5 wingspan at the 2012 NBA Combine. His standing reach is actually 3.5 inches greater than that of Anthony Davis. Wow.
Wow, that's right. To the inside. And down it goes. Dunk through off a wonderful assist.
That's leadership. Really, really valuable to have someone who can just take charge like he has.
Well, there's a certain amount of confidence you have when the ball is in his hands at that end of the floor right now. I mean, he just gives you a sense of calm and confidence because of how good he is.
Carroll with the three. That's in. That's his fifth field goal. He's shooting a hot 71%, 5 for 7. Outside, Jack. Ginobili outside. And Jack, here we go. And another miss by Cleveland.
And that's a well-contested shot.
Well, we've seen him before. He does not allow you to just get easy baskets. He's always going to make you work for it.
Paul against Jack. Paul's shot is off. For the Cleveland Cavaliers, they come in off the loss to the Kings. Outside, Jack. There's a screen. Six to shoot. Pass to Serafin. From the line. And the shot falls short this time. Mavericks leading by 19. And here's Green outside. Carroll passes to Paul. Henson dishes to Paul. To the middle. Here's Carroll. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Carroll's got 9 points here in the second half. Clark, they've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a little bit of cotton mouth here. Dry spell for sure.
Duncan with a screen on Green. Ginobili kicks to Duncan. No good off the front iron.
I think he was surprised by how much space he had there and just rushed the shot a little bit.
Paul with the ball. Now Jack defending. The drive by Paul. And it goes out of bounds. That went off Duncan. Allen's checked in for the Cavaliers. Rondo comes in for Jarrett Jack. Josh McRoberts has checked in for the Mavericks. And guys, Tim Duncan still dominant after 18 years. You know, he's reshaped his body. He has gotten a brand new diet, which he says has had a huge benefit. We saw it in the playoffs last year. Greg, I think, you know, he probably was one of the top 5 overall performers in last year's playoffs.
No doubt about it. We continue to write this guy off, Kevin, and he just continues to defy Father Time. I mean, there was a point where he was starting to feel the wear and tear, especially in his knees, but being the competitor he is, he decided to dictate to his body rather than letting his body dictate to him.
You know, one aspect of their play today that's really been tight and far superior is their passing.
And that kind of flow can be elusive, but the great offenses have it, and that's just what they've shown here tonight.
The dish now to Allen. Once again, off the mark by Cleveland.
You know, getting back to Duncan, when you talk to his teammates, they'll tell you he's disciplined. He maintains a strict diet, does off-the-floor training, from boxing to swimming, throwing tires, running in the sand. That keeps him motivated and engaged.
And here's Thornton outside. Good, and Paul gets the assist. Thornton's got 6 in the quarter. And what's your take, guys, on the hustle sticks for Dallas?
Their high-energy defensive effort has paid off for them, guys, with more than a few steals over the course of the ballgame.
Yeah, but they've also done a great job of playing in space, getting out in transition every opportunity.
Again, Pierce missing.
In talking about Duncan's new look, Coach Popovich had an interesting quote. Pop said, I look at him and tell him, you look like Sprewell used to look. Just skin and bones, ligaments and tendons. I mean, but you know what? You can't argue with success, and not many people have had more than Tim Duncan.
Paul. And Dallas again with the bucket.
Wow, got that one off right in the face of the big fella. Nice quick fire release.
Yeah, and the mid-range shot really the only option in that situation. Sometimes when you're facing a bigger guy, you can't get it all the way to the rim.
Taken away. Let's it go from the wing. Again, the miss by Paul.
No doubt he's struggling right now from the field. Let's see if he can get it going this quarter. It's still pretty early to judge, but so far the 2014 draft class has lived up to the hype. The top guys were as good as promised, and a lot of talent down later in the draft as well.
Patrick Patterson, he's checked in for Cleveland.
TJ Warren comes in for Pierce.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for the Mavericks.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, I thought, Stephen Clark. An all-around dominant performance. Clark, and you kind of thought that maybe even going into the game.
I certainly did, and they just cracked it open and made it an NC. No contest.
Yeah, I like that. And this will be a big win for them. Lucky win number 13 now in the bag.
And guys, being in opposite conferences, these teams only meet twice a year, and when it's been a while since you've seen a team like this, it always feels good to take the first game of the season series, and that's exactly what's taking place here tonight against the Cavaliers.
And we've come to expect nothing less from one of the league's elite players, but another tour de force for Chris Paul. He just looked like an orchestrator out there. His teammates kept running to the open spot, and he found them time and time again.
Sessions checked in for Rajon Rondo. Roten dishes to Aldridge. Pass to McRoberts. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
Check out the game for McRoberts. He's got 8 points now and three great steals. Oh my gosh, I just got
him. So he makes one of two as the second one misses. So far, we've seen them be a bit careless with the ball.
Guys, untidy. You've got to value the possession of the basketball.
Simply put, out of control is how they play thus far. They're going to have to reel it in and show some more discipline.
Now, here's Roten. So no problem for Dallas as they get the win. A resounding victory for them. And, Greg, in enemy territory, no less.
That's exactly right. But with the way they controlled the game and just completely took the crowd out of it, that's how to get it done on the road.
And that about wraps it up. For Greg Anthony, Doris...